Well, it's kind of a broad subject in a way. We're trying to meld together two concepts of architecture, which is probably kind of a man-made intention to change or to live in or habitable structures. And then we have nature, and which we call more sustainable design, how to match man or people-built environments into the natural environment.
It's not easy being green, having to spend each day the color of the leaves. When I think it could be nicer being red or yellow or gold or something much more colorful like that. It's not easy being green. It seems you blend in with so many other ordinary things, and people tend to pass you over.
So by that we helped the heat island effect, which makes it more habitable for people and other creatures who want to habitate with us. And then helps the stormwater, creates habitat for butterflies and any animals that can live out there. And it also creates beauty, and it creates a longer roof. You don't have the infrared beating on these roofs, and in some cases it doubles the life of the roof. So there's probably seven or eight things that happen, good for the ecology, good for us.
Thank you. only dream I ever have. The stars of the sun. Every time I shut my eyes, it's always the same.